Hello student, Angle chapter. In the previous videos we have completed the chapter till problem set 24. Okay, I have explained you how we can name the angles and vertex and arms of an angle. What is mean by arms of an angle and name or how we can read that angle, we have learned in the previous. Okay, if you're not seen that video, please go and check that video. Okay, so here next topic is your protractor. Like if you want to measure any line, which device you are using? You are using scale. Okay, if you want to measure this line, how we can measure? We will take this from zero, and whatever the measurement it will be, you will measure. Here it is 2.5. Now if you want to measure the angle, how we can measure? Can we use this scale to measure the angle? No, we can't use the scale for measuring the angle. Now what to do, how we can measure the angle? Okay, so we can use protractor for measuring the angle. You can see in this figure, this is protractor. Okay, like that when you will buy a geometry box, you will find this protractor in that box. Okay, so this is your protractor and this is going to be used for measuring the angle. Okay, so first of all we'll see the information, it is given in your textbook. First of all we'll read that information and we will check that. Here the protractor is a semicircular in shape. As you can see here, the protractor is semicircular in shape. Okay, it is not full in circle, it is half circle. You can see here it is half of the circle. Okay, so next, the semicircular edges of a protractor is divided into 180 equal part. Okay, so here as you can see the protractor, always whenever you are measuring anything, always starting from zero. Okay, so here you can see it is 0 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. This is 90, which is perpendicular to the line. Okay, so this will be a 90 degree. Then 100, 110, 120, 130, 140, and 150, and 160, and 170, and 180. Now you will think about why the upper number is written. It is why, because if you want to measure from this side, you can use this downside number. But if you want to measure any angle from this side, you can use the 0 from here. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, like that. But always, whenever which side we are measuring, just check the zeros and always start from 0. Clear? When how we can measure, we will learn about afterwards. First of all, just it is just information about the protractor. Okay, so as you know that it is from zero, it will start from zero, but it will end from 180. Why it is ending from 180? Because if you will see this as it is 90 degree. Okay, this will be 90 degree. Angle is measuring in the degree, this is called degree, 8 degree. This 0 is a symbol of degree. Okay, so this is 90 degree and this also will be 90 degree. That means 90 plus 90, how much? It is 180. So the half means this part will be 180 degree angle. Clear? So that's why it is 180. as we told that each part is 180. That means here it is, if you see this from 0, if you will count this number, you will find between this 0 and 10, you will find 10 lines. Okay, so if you will count here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, that means one line is conducting a 1 degree. A small line is having 1 degree. So it is 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, 4 degree, 5 degree, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so this will become 10 degree angle. Okay, afterward also 11, 12, 13, 14, like this, if you will count, you will find this small line is 180 small line you will find. Okay, just count and just find, you will get 180 degree. A small line is you will get 180. Okay, so here it is, means each small line is denoting as 1 degree. So the division on a protractor, the degrees can be marked as two ways. The division 0, 10, 20, 30 from till 180, as we have seen here, from 0 to it will become 180, are marked as anti-clockwise. Okay, or from right to left. As I told you, you can measure from this side also, but whenever you are using this side, you have to start from 0. If you are using from this side, you have to use the upper scale. Clear? And how to use, we'll see afterwards. The center of a circle, of which the protractor is the half part, is called the center of protractor. As you can see this point, this is a center of protractor. If you will divide this, if you will cut, you will get half part of the protector. Clear? And this center is very useful. We have to keep the vertex in the center. And how, we will see in the next part. But yeah, the center of a circle of which the protector is in half part is called a center of protector. A diameter of that circle is the baseline of the line of reflection of the circle. As you can see here, it is diameter. This is your baseline. Clear? This is your baseline. Whenever you will draw, you have to keep one line on the baseline for making the angle. Clear? These are the small information about the protector. And how we will use for drawing, we will see in the next part.